The Afrikaner Nationalist Party is gaining traction in Sophia Town. Freehold township on the west of Johannesburg is still predominantly inhabited by folks racialized as black. Miriam Makeba, the Manhattan Brothers, the Pitch Black Follies, Dorothy Masuka, Dolly Ratebe, the Mary Blackbirds, all of whom recorded under Gallo music and came up in Sophia Town, Johannesburg.
I tell you what, there was just an army of fabulous musicians that came out of this country. I mean, across all the racial groups, across all the eras, the generic variety is really quite astonishing.
These original sounds, you know, that way we're born with.
Eventually, what came out of it was bubblegum. It was kind of a bizarre reaction. All of these sort of overtly American-influenced bands.
Brenda's doing straight pop out of the 80s American catalog, but underneath it, I began to recognize, oh, that was the thing that was getting me. When you kill the bass and you bring up the tops and the mids, you can hear the Tsonga woman shaking their shibela line. The Tsonga rhythms. The undertone that were responding to was something of themselves.
In the early 90s, Kwaito, with its mid-tempo dance beat, evolved from baganga, dancehall, house, disco, and hip-hop, leads a post-apartheid township subculture into the mainstream. And by the late 90s and early 2000s, Gallo music finds itself leaning into the evolution of new hybrid, genre-bending, border-defying sounds from South Africa's black youth. Tandiswa Mazwai, Simpiwe Dana, Squatter Camp, and Pro Kid are all standout names from this era who spoke to life under a new, complex socio-political dispensation. Street on a Saturday zone ends up peace. You see how they feel this singla. Choose go to Siggy's. Mamela Nufla Baba Fanaxazo Babi Chilis. Once again, I'm Tula Namato Tageko Sazo Piggies. See this shy Tula Mabodanjango Mawilis.